Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. So many of the students ask me how to clearly differentiate between vitamin B9, that is a folic acid, as well as vitamin B12, because both of them have most of the things that are similar to each other. But coming to the board's point of view, if there is a question, it can be of vitamin B9 or it can be of vitamin B12. But you have to know the clear differentiation between vitamin B9 and B12 so that you can answer the questions without being wrong. Now, how do you answer the question is, first of all, you have to, I'll just give you a little introduction about B9 as well as B12. Look, folic acid and cyanocobalamin, both of them are found in the plant material. Mainly folic acid is rich in green leafy vegetables. When I tell that if it is rich in green leafy vegetables, if a person has stopped eating green leafy vegetables and is completely dependent upon processed canned foods, of course he will have a deficiency of vitamin B9. So in the question, whenever you are doing any question of USMLE or IFOM or any question, in the question if you find that the patient is constantly dependent on the canned foods or the processed foods, then he's more likely to experience vitamin B9 deficiency. That is a folic acid deficiency, right? So better write it down. The next thing is, coming to vitamin B12, what is the most common cause of vitamin B12 deficiencies? First of all, you have to know from where vitamin B12 is getting absorbed. Look, the first thing, in the stomach, you have intrinsic factor. For example, if generally this intrinsic factor is released by the parietal cells. For example, if there is a dysfunction of the parietal cells due to gastric ulcers, will vitamin B12 be absorbed? No. So patient will have vitamin B12 deficiency. The second thing, if due to chronic gastric ulcers, what you have to do is you have to remove the stomach, gastrectomy. So in case of gastrectomy also, you'll have vitamin B12 deficiency. And third important thing is, vitamin B12 is absorbed through the terminal part of the ileum. If you resect the terminal part of the ileum, why do you resect the terminal part of the ileum? Because there is a disease called as Crohn's disease, which can affect any part of the gastrointestinal tract from the mouth till the anus. But most commonly it affects your terminal part of the ileum. So when it affects your terminal part of the ileum, and if it is severe, you have to resect it. Now when you resect it, vitamin B12 deficiency happens, right? So these are the three most important things. You have to look in the case that whether the patient previously had any gastrectomy or previously had any gastric ulcers that are affecting the parietal cells, or previously he had been treated for Crohn's disease by resecting the terminal ileum. So these three things will point you towards vitamin B12 deficiency. Now, next thing, for example, if you drink a lot of alcohol in chronic alcoholics, both vitamin B9 and B12, both will be deficient. But vitamin B9 deficiency occurs very quickly because most of the vitamin B9, which is left over in our body after its usage, it will be stored in the liver. So in chronic alcoholics, the first organ to be affected is the liver. So, of course, vitamin B12 levels will be depleted. Vitamin B12 deficiency occurs within 4 to 5 months. But whereas it takes years for vitamin B12 deficiency to develop. So, you have to look at the question. If the patient is a chronic alcoholic for about 6 months or for about 4 months or 5 months, he has been drinking a lot of alcohol and so on. There are a few symptoms below that. So, then you have to point towards folic acid, because folic acid deficiency is more common in chronic alcoholics than in vitamin B12 deficiency patients. Next thing, coming to the labs, you see, both of them cause megaloblastic anemia, right? Both of them cause megaloblastic anemia with hypersegmented neutrophils. If you want, you can Google a pic of hypersegmented neutrophils, how do they look like? So these hypersegmented neutrophils, I mean, in the question, they'll give you the entire case. At the end, they'll give you that we found this in the patient's blood report. In the patient's blood smear, we found this picture. What is this picture? The picture is of hypersegmented neutrophils. Now, these hypersegmented neutrophils are found both in B9 at the same time found in B12 deficiency. Now, how will you differentiate both of them? Really, you cannot differentiate because both of them share the same similarities. Now, how you will differentiate is go to MCV. MCV in the sense mean corpuscular volume, which will measure the size of the RBC, size of the cell. But the thing is, even MCV is also increased in both of them because both of them lead to megaloblastic anemia. So the cell size will be increased. So MCV will be increased in both of them. Now, when there are such two similarities, then now how you will identify that? You have to identify not based upon the labs, instead based upon the symptoms. Write it down now. The most important thing I'm going to tell, the symptoms are, if there is vitamin B12 deficiency, the characteristic symptoms will be neurological findings. But in folic acid deficiency, you won't find any neurological findings. In a case, if they give you patient is a chronic alcoholic, second thing, if they didn't give you any kind of neurological symptoms, third thing, in the labs they give you highest MCV normal value is 80 to 100 femtoliter. If they give more than that, fourth thing, if they give hypersegmented neutrophils, then you have to point it for folate deficiency. Coming to vitamin B12 deficiency, in the case, they might give you chronic alcoholism or no, that doesn't matter. But if it is vitamin B12 deficiency, then definitely they'll give you neurological findings. Neurological findings like the patient was complaining of tingling, patient was complaining of numbness, patient was complaining of weakness, that is paresthesia, and patient was complaining of hyporeflexia. I mean, he don't know what is hyporeflexia, but on examination, you'll get to know it is hyporeflexia. So these are all of them are neurological findings. These findings you will find only in vitamin B12 deficiency patients. So while doing the question, if it is chronic alcoholism, patient is a chronic alcoholic, in the mind, you need to have two things, B9, B12. Now next, go for the next one. Next one is look whether the patient is having neurological findings or no. If it is no, then point towards folate deficiency. If it is yes, patient is showing neurological findings, then go for the third thing. Third thing is labs. Check MCV. MCV must be more than 100. If MCV is more than 100, then immediately go for the picture. I mean, they'll be giving you the picture of the patient's blood smear. And in the picture, if you find hypersegmented neutrophils, then that's it. It is vitamin B12 deficiency, right? So these are some things which you need to know. Okay. So one difference what I told you is based upon the patient complaints. As I told you, in folate there is no neurological findings, whereas in B12 neurological findings are there. But okay, leaving the symptoms, I want to differentiate in terms of lab values. Now how will you differentiate in terms of lab values? As I told you, MCV will be similar, there will be megaloblastic anemia in both of them, there will be hypersegmented neutrophils, but still there is one thing which you can differentiate in the labs. This is the level of homocysteine and the level of methylmalonyl coenzyme A. Look here. Normally, vitamin B12 converts methylmalonyl CoA to succinyl CoA. Right? Vitamin B12 converts methylmalonyl-CoA to succinyl-CoA. And vitamin B12 also converts homocysteine to methionine. Right? Remember one thing. Write it down. Vitamin B12 helps as a cofactor in converting methylmalonyl-CoA to succinyl-CoA and homocysteine to methionine. For example, if there is deficiency of vitamin B12, then what will happen? Can methylmalonyl-CoA be converted to succinyl-CoA? No. So there will be raised increased level of methylmalonyl CoA. On the other hand, I told you, homocysteine is converted to methionine. If vitamin B12 deficiency is there, what will happen? Homocysteine level will be more. So methylmalonyl CoA and homocysteine, both of their levels will be raised. But coming to the folic acid can only convert homocysteine to methionine, but it cannot convert methylmalonyl CoA to succinyl CoA. So if there is folic acid deficiency, what will happen? Only homocysteine levels will be increased, not methylmalonyl CoA. So this is the prime difference which you need to know. So coming to the labs, these are the things. So as I told you, first thing, patient complaints, neurological symptoms. Second thing, these compounds. That's it. And third thing to put your mind into B12, B9 deficiencies, hypersegmented neutrophils with increased MCV, right? So that's it. So if you have written all the points which I have told you, then definitely you'll answer any MCQ related to folic acid as well as vitamin B12 deficiency, right? So that's it. Thank you. Thank you for watching my video. Please subscribe to my channel, Medico Tutorials. Signing off, Krishna.